this video, we will learn how to install DL Workbench on your machine so that you can start experimenting with your model and how it works on different types of the hardware, on the CPU, on the GPU, neural compute stick 2, or the HDDL. So once we have decided to install the OpenVINO DL Workbench, we can read more about this tool in the official documentation. For that, we need to go to the docs openvinotoolkit.org, and there we can easily navigate to the sections that describe the OpenVINO DL Workbench. So here we can read more about the deep learning workbench, what are the main components, how it is organized, and then we can proceed to the installation guide. There, we will read about the prerequisites that are required to be installed in the system. So, in short, in order to have the DL Workbench running on your system, you need to have Docker installed. In this video, we will learn how to install Docker on all major OSs like Mac, Linux, and Windows. So, we begin with installation of Docker on Mac, and for that, we need to download their Docker desktop for Mac, which is the traditional Mac application that you need to download, put in the applications folder. And after you have done that, you need to run that application and then take a look at the status bar at the top of the screen. If you see the small whale there, and when you hover over this whale and see that the Docker desktop is running, then you're good to go and proceed to running DL Workbench on your system. Now let's talk a bit about how to install Docker on Windows. The situation is pretty the same. You download the installer, install it as a plain Windows application, and then you need to run this application. For that, just find it in the Windows search. After that, go to the status bar, and if you recognize that little whale, and when you hover, it says that Docker desktop is running, then you're good to go and proceed with running DL Workbench on your Windows machine. Installing Docker on Ubuntu and on Linux systems in general is a bit more sophisticated. However, there is a nice tutorial from the Docker team that we just follow in order to install Docker on the Ubuntu 20.04. So we remove all old installations of Docker, then we proceed to adding the new repository and installing Docker from that repository. Once we have installed the Docker, we need to make sure that it is working. And we can do that by pulling the sample Hello World image. And once we've done that, we can see that it successfully downloaded, and it means that Docker has installed. However, there is an extremely important final step that you need to follow, and it is adding your user to the Docker group. So we do that by using this special command, and after that, you are able to run Docker without sudo. It is a highly recommended way, and you will need this when running DL Workbench on the system. So we have installed Docker on our operation system. What is next? And the next step, of course, is running the DL Workbench. Before we start running DL Workbench, we need to understand one simple thing. If we want to experiment with numerous accelerators, like I said, GPU, neural compute stick 2, HDDL cards, then we need Ubuntu system. If we're working on Mac and Windows, only CPU is available as the accelerator. So now we can start running the DL Workbench on our system. So first of all, we need to understand what is the latest version of the OpenVINO DL Workbench. For that, we go to the DockerHub and see that there are several tags, and the most recent one is 20.21.2. And this version we are going to use in this video. In order to run DL Workbench on the Mac system, we need to pull the image first. For that, we copy this command, and it is recommended to provide the tag that we just saw on the DockerHub page. So we pull the image, check that it is in the list, and now we need to run the DL Workbench. We can use one of the commands available in the instructions. I will use the most simple one. Here it is, just copying it, pasting it to the terminal, And in a few moments, we see that DL Workbench has started. And there is a special link in the terminal that we need to follow. And here you are. Here is the DL Workbench running on your system. When we want to run DL Workbench on Windows, situation is pretty much the same. We need to pull the image by selecting the command from the documentation and providing the proper tag. When it is there, we need to select one of the commands in the instructions. There are several instructions, but we will use the simplest one. We copy it and execute in the terminal. After we do that, in a few moments, we can see the DL Workbench is running on the localhost port 5665. And then we visit this page and see that DL Workbench is running and is available for your experiments. So as we discussed, the most complete list of available accelerators is on the Linux system. So to run the DL Workbench on the Linux system is pretty much the same as we did that on Mac and Windows. However, as there are more accelerators available, there are more options to be used, and we have made a special script that encapsulates all the complexity of running Workbench on the Linux system. So we need to obtain the script that I was talking about, which is called star-workbench-sh. After that, we need to make sure that it is executable, and then we can review all the available options, how to run Docker container on the Linux system. So make sure that you have selected the proper instructions for the accelerators that you have on your machine, and then copy the command and execute it in the terminal. After you have done that, DL Workbench appears and you can start experimenting and uploading your model or selecting one of the models from the open model zone. So, congratulations, you have your Workbench running on your operation system, whether it is Mac, Linux, or Windows. And now you can start experimenting with your model and benchmarking it, optimizing it for various accelerators, preparing your model for deployment, or even analyzing how your model works, what is its output, how it is optimized, and how it is executed on the target hardware. If you have some special feedback or you want to make some special feature request, maybe you have some troubles working with the Workbench, please let us know by using the official forum. The link to that forum is available in the description. So thank you again. Bye-bye.